for G fans, you're truly here, and I know, it's already 2018. It's gone by so fast. Well, I hope for this upcoming year, everyone has big time fitness goals to look good and feel great for this upcoming year. So one of the main questions I get asked a lot is hamstring development. Now remember, hamstrings are part of your core muscles, because remember, it's your lower back, it's your hips, it's your butt, as well as your hamstrings too, and hip flexors. It's a combination of everything, because that's where all movement begins. So, after my deadlift workout today, I implemented some accessory exercises to further strengthen and enhance the development of my hamstrings. Some of the exercises consist of good old-fashioned good mornings with a specialty bar on the cable bar, which I absolutely love, that no other gym seemed to have that works on back development as well. I also did lying down or pronated leg curls, bilateral movement, and I supersetted that as well with a standing unilateral movement or single leg curl, just to bring better overall balance and development with my left and right hamstring. Now naturally, because I'm right-handed dominant, whenever I throw something or push something, I always step with my opposite leg, my left leg. So my left hamstring, my quads in general, is much more strong and more stable versus my right. So that's where those unilateral movements come into play to promote great health and prevent injury. Also, I did a hip extension or a bridge with a physio ball with accommodating resistance with a skinny black Superman or rubber band attached behind my ankles. So every time I raise my hips up and force my heels into my glutes, I had to stretch that band for resistance. Remember, in order to strengthen joints and muscles and the movement, you must go against resistance. Don't just rely on your body weight, because just remember, your body itself can only handle so much. You have to start pushing yourself, especially if you want to see big gains in overall strength and appearance for 2018. Also, I implemented my famous and favorite, reverse hyperextension to decompress my lower back and activate my glutes and hamstrings as well. Now just remember, your hamstrings assist with hip extension and knee flexion. If you're an athlete or if you're a person who sits down all day long with a desk or a student, whatever, chances are pretty high you have very tight hamstrings because your knees flex the whole time. So we gotta start moving around, you gotta be more active when it comes to strength training and activities itself. Make sure stretch your hamstrings. I can never stress enough. A lot of us tend to go right into our workout and do our deadlifts or squats or whatever the case may be, and we pull our hamstrings, or we go straight to a run without properly warming up. So what that leads is to injury, pain, discomfort, depression, and you're very limited. So make sure implement your hip mobility exercises, do your dynamic warm up and cool down at the end of your workout. And until then, I'll see you soon.